Hi, I'm Michael Caton-Jones. I'm the director of Urban Hymn. It's a story about two girls in care and the social worker who looks after them. It's essentially a very simple story. She tries to help them rehabilitate their lives or look forward to something. But it was the idea that I could work with three female leads was one of the strongest things that attracted me to it. Also, I believe you can make films which are about real things that don't have to be miserable or serious or anything like that. I feel as though that kind of filmmaking was done in Britain a lot, and it's sort of been lost in a way. Well, to be honest, the riots is only a backdrop for the kickoff of the film. It doesn't actually feature much in it. The aftermath of it features a little. But really, it was simply an inciting incident that you can use to start a story off. I think even if you didn't have riots, the stories of these people would have been the same, pretty much. It's not something that's that is due to the riots or only defined by the riots. I think there's a general dissatisfaction for teenagers and especially the ones in care, and I think that's sort of there all the time.
In terms of casting teenagers, can you talk about your two young leads and the remarkable qualities that they bring to these performances?
I think the two young girls are fantastic. I think these are two of the best performances you'll see all year. They are not showy, and they're not look at me, you know. They're performances where they sink themselves into the characters, and you admire them because you believe that character and you believe what they're going through. The film industry is in for a big surprise when they see these two girls. They're really fantastic.
And on a more experienced end of the spectrum, obviously you have the luminous talents of Shirley Henderson, who's standing next to you at the moment. Can you talk a little bit about the importance of having her on board to complete that triangle?
Yeah. Well, in the story, she plays a sort of social worker who's trying to mentor one of them. And in real life, she did a bit of that with the girls as well. They were full of the joys of life, and she was very experienced. And she kept them, she kept them in kind of control and kept them focused on what they had to focus on to do the work. And I think they learned an immense amount from her. But the quality she brings to a film is immeasurable in a way. She brings a kind of veracity and a believability that not a lot of actors have got, and a lack of vanity, which not a lot of actors have got, which I think kind of set a touchstone for the rest of the film, how to play the rest of the film.
Of course, music is another big character in the film. Can you talk a little bit about working on that specific element and what you feel the power of music is as this film celebrates?
Well, one of the things that I wanted to do in the first place was to make a film about the transcendental power of music, you know, about what music means to you, about how it makes you feel, and if you hear something, why it triggers this. I think everybody's got that in their life, and it's different for every person. So I kind of felt I wanted to make a musical, but not one where they stopped for a song, but that actually the characters within the story were using music as, you know, in a natural way. So there was a whole bunch of reasons that I was interested in sort of mixing up the genres in a way.
I guess my final question, what's coming up next for you at the moment?
I can't tell you. I'm in New York at the moment in pre-production on a film, but it's not been announced yet, so I can't tell you yet.